international exhibition we went to see in Rome. They had very nice things there, you see. Some were selling some fur, some were selling some things you see made in their own country, some beads, very nice handmade things in everything. And also beautiful inlay work and all that. And suddenly they said this is the stall of England. So I deliberately went there. And what do you think it was?
Our greatest
punk rock things.
Really?
You know, 5-colored pants, 4-colored shirt, these wigs, all made with hair. All made with hair. And fuzzy dresses for ladies, you see.
As long as they don't think everybody in England is like that.
I mean, it is so bad of them to put it there. I mean, horrid. And the one lady who was there, she was wearing a very funny dress, extremely funny and cute. And the gentleman, you didn't come that day, now you were not.
No.
And the gentleman was wearing another funny dress with his sheet like that, cock-like thing, all colored. And they were doing a very dirty dance there, very dirty dance. And everybody were, you see, I think Italians have a sense of ridicule.
Yes.
They have a sense of ridicule. And they were all making fun of that. Mm-hmm. All of them were making fun of that.
Actually, Rome is, it's got certain negative qualities, but the general quality of people is...
They have a sense of serenity, you see.
Mm.
By photograph itself, they understand.
Yes.
You see, to understand photograph to that extent, and what respect and veneration they have for.
Mm.
Thousands they were that day, yes. When we went to the big hall.
Yes.
You should see the way they behaved, and everyone got up, and so respectful.
They just wanted to come and touch mother, or they didn't bother her with fix my knee, fix my uncle, fix my aunt.
Not
just touch her and walked away, and it's so beautiful.
See, traditional, they are traditional people, that's why.
Very much.
I think they are
very
traditional. I've seen Egyptians have that, Greek people have this.
Romans.
Rome people have. It's traditional people, you see, whatever it is, tradition is tradition. They might have been horrid Romans. But you see, by living for so many years, you commit all the errors and you correct. So I think traditional people improve. And that's why in Europe, England is the best as far as the young people is concerned.
Yes. Yes. We went to Cambridge. Dumal and myself went to Cambridge. We had a really beautiful time there. And we just enjoyed the cathedral. We saw the beautiful painting in the cathedral of the Adoration of the Magi. The whole place has a serenity.
I've not seen anything in Cambridge.
Haven't you, Mother? You must see that cathedral.
Cambridge University, remember, Mother? Remember Cambridge University?
Yeah.
We had a program at Cambridge University.
And I came away. First was horrible. Second one was only, there were 5 people. Out of them, 3 ran away. And the fourth one that was left, her boyfriend came, and she ran away too. So only the one left was Anu's wife, you see. She got a realization.
They had good
experience. After that, Anu was so angry, you know. It rained and blasted. And Vishnumaya was so hard. I haven't seen such tempest. And it was in the papers that Cambridge had never known such lashing.
Mm.
Absolutely. I mean, we were not at all troubled. You see, our car was moving and the thing was behind us. Never touched us. No water, nothing on our car. But what I thought that instead of going to London now, let's go to Northampton where our Jamail was. So went to his house. Then I cooked a meal for them and we all ate.
Oh, yes,
you
told me that.
Loving was we were.
I think, Mother, it might be a good idea if we had ashrams that were outside London, but near enough for us to have programs inside. But maybe it's something about living actually...
Not south. Southern people are horrible.
But actually living in London, I think it's quite a problem, actually being in the middle of it all.
But north, we can have it in the north of London.
Yes.
Queen's Park's in the north.
Yes, but if you're a little bit removed from it, you know, like you can go down to the city and work it out, but then you can come out again and clear out, whereas when you're in the middle of London, it's quite difficult to maintain that sort of serenity.
Tranquility.
Yes.
But Surbitency was a good place. But the people, surrounding people were horrid and very aggressive, typically of southern type of people. Because first I lived in Oxford, they were all like this, you see. Very aggressive people.
They're the real right-siders of England. The people in the Midlands are very good people.
Yes, they've got great hearts.
And the people in the north are too much so. They overindulge the familiarity and, you know...
Oh, they are drunk all
the far north,
Scotland.
Yes.
We were going to this run-up place. Our train reached what time? About 12 o'clock. And we had to... Remember, Nick, you were there at that time, no?
No, I didn't go anymore.
Not that.
When you went to Scotland?
First time when we went to Ronak. And we had to take a train to go to Ronak, you see. And they said you have to go from another station. So we walked. We wanted to know which side is the station. But every person we met at that time, about 12:30 or so, was drunk. Can you imagine? Mm. Drunk at 12:30 in the daytime. Yeah, we just thought, what sort of thing? Is this? And we didn't know whom to ask, because one fellow went into the restaurant to ask, so they were all drinking there. So he came with the greater speed than he had entered. Well, 30 they were drunk. Imagine what a place it must be.
Crazy.
Horrible. But it has. We have tried Scotland. Poor Gavin, you see, he's very anxious about Scotland. But this time he went there, he came back, he said, Mother, don't go. Now, please don't go to Scotland.
Where are you from, Graham?
I was born near London.
But they did well in that Ireland. Ireland they did well, and again there was a, you see, because they were, nobody was in contact, so they wrote a letter saying that Mother should come once and this and that. I said, all right, we'll see about it.
The thing about Ireland was, with Dublin, was that horrible psychiatrist who was a friend of the family, who all got their realization, do you remember?
He was disciple of this Satya Sai Baba.
Yeah, Sai Baba.
He must have already got a heart attack, I'm sure. Was catching so much on the heart that time only. That Rustam was saying, Mother, he must be out already.
Yes.
The way he's having, don't pay your attention, he said to him, let him die, we don't want him there. I said, not to say. He said, he's catching so much on the heart that he's not going to survive. Rustam is doing well.
Mm-hmm.
He is giving realization to people. You see what he says, that he calls them, and he puts some sort of a cover on my photograph so they can't see it, you see. And they said, now put your hand towards the wall, you see, like this.
Muslims like a blank wall. They do.
And he gives them realization, you see. He goes on their back and puts his hand. They don't understand what's happening. They're getting well, mad people getting well, alcoholics getting well.